Okay, brace yourselves. Now we're going to talk about the drugs previously known as, or sometimes known as, or in some circles referred to as, atypical antipsychotics for historical reasons. That's where they first got studied, just like MAOIs in tuberculosis, just like anticonvulsants in mood disorders, just like beta blockers and baking soda in pancakes. With me? So arguably, this is the Death Star from Star Wars. This thing has more machinery and military might than you could imagine. I got that off the internet because we started by talking about Swiss Army knives. What do you think of that? You want to get an airplane with that? I was going to bring one on the plane. I realized I wouldn't make it to Denver. But you know, with great effect comes great cost. Do you know what that Swiss Army knife goes for on Amazon? Guess. $40? No. $400? No. I'll give you a hint. There's no generic. And it requires double secret prior authorization. You'll find that on Amazon for $9,000. But it will do everything you want. It will wash your car. It will pay your children's tuition. It will feed you. It will clothe you. It will house you. It's a bargain. Well, enough about Swiss Army knives. Atypical antipsychotics, like good Swiss Army knives, perform lots of functions. How unfortunate that you are asked to pay 10 grand for a hunk of metal that was developed in wartime to help soldiers open their cans of rations, when in fact it does all these things. So look at all these receptor profiles and systems that these drugs go around trolling for. Not just the monoamines, the noradrenergic system, not just every serotonergic receptor you could hope to learn about at NEI. Ooh, I learned I could block 5-HT2C and that'll raise my dopamine. Vladimir told you that. I could block 5-HT2A and do all kinds of wonderful things for depression. I could block 5-HT7 and make you smarter. I could block D1 at low doses. I mean, you know, you could spend as much time discussing this as you could discussing that. The point being, to call that a knife or to call that an antipsychotic, well, you get it. It's disingenuous.